By the end of this video, you're going to learn exactly how to use Bolt and know what to do after your initial prompt. There are some cool features in Bolt, so we're going to go through those too. And the prompt for this video is a simple landing page for a lawn maintenance individual. The call to action is for people to fill in a simple form, make it modern looking, simple, and focus on the call to action. So I'll click this button and come back when it's ready. This is what it has come up with. So you can see it's kept this very simple landing page with a landscape theme. So it's chosen the green colors here. We're not going to focus too much on what this looks like and what you can use this for. And so we're going to go through this interface and talk about what you need to do next. So let's start with the chat on the left. So this is where you're going to interact using natural language with the AI agent in order to make changes. And there are different ways to do this because we have a discussion feature here, discuss mode, where you can actually just chat with this in a way that is not going to make changes to the code. And this is a great feature to help you come up with plans for what to do next and also for Bolt to help you decide what to do next and how to make changes. So you can toggle this on and off and decide if you want to use this or not. You can also upload files here, and this works really well when you want to take a screenshot of something and be able to explain it here. Now, there's another way to do this to focus on a specific part of this, which we'll talk about soon. And let's just say you want to say, change the design. We can use this enhance prompt feature. If we click this, then it's going to enhance the prompt for us. And you can see it goes into depth with this. Now, this is a little bit like creating a PRD. Now, watch our video on that. I'll leave a link in the description. But whenever you do this, it's important that you review this first. And in fact, it leaves things in these parentheses so that you can put in your specific information. Now, before we go into the integrations, export, and deploy, we also have these buttons here. And one of them is specifically helpful if you want to update the title or these different types of boxes or any elements. But first we have code, where you can actually look at the code here and you can search the code so that you know exactly what's working here, and you can go in and update this code too. If we go back to preview and then go over here, we can open the preview in a separate tab. And I like to do this when I want to focus on the website or the app without getting distracted by everything else. And it's also a good way for you to test out the different buttons and to see if things are working well. Now, going back to this, we can also toggle between responsive mode, and we can change the different type of phone here. We can enter a full screen within the Bolt preview. And then this button here is the inspector. So if we click this button, we can inspect the different elements within the design. And if you click on this element, you can see it says H1. And then you can get specific about this. So when you've clicked on this element here, any prompt will reference this element too. So if we scroll down, inspector, we can inspect this icon here, the header, the text, or the whole element as well. And also we can choose larger elements too to make changes to this section here. Now you can do that, but you could also use this button here to upload a file of the screenshot as well. So at this point, you'll probably make some changes to this, change the different types of copy as well in here. And then if you know code or you want to do a little bit of search with the code, then you can change things here as well. So this is especially useful if you want to change some of the text without going into the chat mode here. So I can change this to exceptional lawn care. Click save, go to preview, and it's changed it here. Now, going back to the top, we can toggle the different project visibilities here. So we can call it the project title. You can change this name too. You can have a secret accessible URL, and it's just changes this as I click it, public or private if you want to keep it for you. Now, these next few features are really useful because we have integrations where we can have these suggested integrations through Stripe and Supabase. So Supabase allowed you to create this database or add the database to the project. And then Stripe allows you to take payments to your projects. And if we click one of these, it's actually going to integrate it here and we can add our Stripe API key. So you'll need to create the Stripe account and then follow the rest of the instructions in order to implement this. We do have videos on how to implement Stripe and accept payments for Liverpool and Boat, so I'll leave that in the description because some of the steps can be a little bit tricky, especially in this part here. So those are the different integrations. Export means now you can open it in Stackblitz where you can edit the code in there, or you can download the code too. And that's one of the biggest benefits of using something like Bolt. You can download the code and take it with you. And then there's this big blue button on the right. When you're ready, you can deploy. And what it's going to do is it's going to deploy this to Netlify. And it's just going to do all of this for you. And then, as you'll see in a moment, you'll need to claim the URL. So it says your site has been successfully deployed. You can view it here. To transfer this Netlify project to your own account, you can use this claim URL. So by clicking this, then this project will become yours within Netlify. And then you have it hosted on this Netlify account with the URL. Now, there are different steps you can take as well to make the URL your own, but this is the simple way just to get started straight away. So those are the key features with Bolt. You're going to find yourself going back and forth with the AI agent. And if you want to learn more about Bolt and watch us build real apps, then check out the playlist in the description. We'll also leave a playlist to other AI builders. And while you're in the description, go to the link here to get 59 validated AI startup ideas. Just simply enter your email address to get access to this. And then check out nocode.mba. Again, I'll leave a link in the description where you can get unlimited access to 350 plus step-by-step lessons where you'll learn how to build apps, websites, automations, and more using no-code and AI tools taught by the top no-code instructors. So again, just click the link in the description to get access to this. Thank you for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.